told me the same thing that'll make you laugh or make you cry. And they was right on the money. Now I bang bang to the rhythm of quick. Now put a dip.
First off, shout out to Rain Rain for investigating this before he put out a video, like you're supposed to do. He threw brothers a life jacket on this one. They was trying to bring us under, and he said something about this didn't sit right with him. He did his work, and he came up with this. So he gets full credit, and I will add on commentary. Shout out to TP the Vegan, LJ, 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 Sister Jinx, and the other sisters who support and they understand what we're saying. This is not directed to you. You know this, but sometimes when you hear brothers talk about the women, you might feel a certain way. So you guys know this isn't to you. This has absolutely nothing to do with you. You don't act like them. All right, let's get into it.
Now, what I want y'all to see right here are comments that were left by various people. And if you look closely, notice that almost every comment that was left by a black woman. Most black women, a good 99% on this post, and I've read through almost every comment, and I'm telling you right now, all of them, all black women did not throw on the cape for this woman. But a lot of them were ready to invite her to the cookout. They were amening what she said. They were praising everything that she said, as you can see by some of these memes, in these GIFs and some of the posts. I will leave the link in the description if you would like to see every comment that she left, because I'm not going to go through all of them. They pretty much almost all echoed the same thing. They pretty much okayed and praised everything and every word that she said, coming from a white woman talking down on black men. And she literally generalized every black man. She did not say some. She didn't say most, but she insinuated all. And here you have mostly black women who are praising everything that she said. Let me just remind you that a lot of black women who have dealt with the dusty Negro have said this before, and she doesn't get that type of praise. But a white woman says it, and it's bells and whistles, fireworks, and whatever kind of other celebratory things you could think of that went through this post right here. Now, I'm going to just stop right here, and now this is going to be the kicker. When you do good investigative reporting, you cover everything from every angle. I showed you the front, I showed you the middle, now I'm about to show you the back. Here is a post right here where is the picture of the Tiffany Jolen chick and her, you guessed it, her so-called misogynistic, lazy, unmanicured, untapered hairline black husband. And this isn't even the funniest part of the entire thing. Let me show you what else I found to be very interesting. Now, you can't see what's written in this post right here, but let me just put it this way. She put some very, well, her friend put some very nasty remarks concerning black women, especially two in particular. And the crazy thing is, when I was reading the post, two of them I know. I've actually talked to both of them more so online. I'm not going to tell you who their names are because that's not important. Now, this is the post from the friend talking ill about black women. And this is her, Tiffany Jolen, talking shit about another black woman. This was a plot by her to get women riled up to see if she could have them for an ally, or like this guy said, to get ally points, and it worked like a charm.
Now, I know Tiffany Jolen and her black boyfriend or black fiance is sitting at home cracking up, laughing at black women make fools of themselves. Now, if Tiffany will say that about a black woman, what do you think she feels about the collective of you idiots? Because that's what you are. You made yourself look like a bunch of buffoons. And common sense will tell you, if she dates black men and they tell her that, obviously she doesn't have a problem with it. More than likely, she agrees with them. And after this situation, she really agrees with them because she plays you like a fiddle. And when I say she, it's the white woman. She say jump, you say how high. This is what we've been talking about. And I tell brothers, pay attention, man. This is your enemy. This is your enemy. She doesn't even know how to do any investigative work. She doesn't even know how to investigate and see if it's authentic, because she's not authentic. She wears weaves. She spends billions of dollars a year trying to look like the white woman. So, of course, she's going to listen to her. Skin bleaching is a billion-dollar industry. Of course, she's going to listen to the white woman. And the reason why I picked this picture and not Tiffany Jolen is because this is symbolic to what the black woman has been doing since she's got off the slave ship, and that's following behind this white woman. She did it in the 60s with the feminist movement. Fast forward today, you're seeing it again. And when I say black women are the dumbest women in the history of women of this earth existence, I mean that shit. Kanika Jenkins, that's a prime example. Autopsy comes out. She wasn't raped. She wasn't strangled. She wasn't murdered. She did it to herself. Fast forward to today, Tiffany Jolen, the autopsy comes out. She talks shit about black women too. Y'all dumb as hell. Everyone is laughing at you. And then I was reading comments and saying, well, one black girl said, oh, she's invited to the cookout. And it's like, she's invited to the cookout. She said, this white sister is invited to the cookout. So when a black male brings a white woman to the cookout, all hell breaks loose. But as long as a black woman says she can come to the cookout, then it's fine. You see how they move the goalposts, brothers? And I don't even date white women. I don't have a dog in a fight, but I'm a black male, and this is my image at stake also. So I'm coming out firing. Then you have black women writing comments. I mean, they are indulging in this, brothers. This is better than the movie Get Out. Then they're saying black men are broke. We've been saying this for years. Black women, you have a net worth of $5. You're the last person on earth calling someone broke. You're saying black women have been saying this for years, but when a white woman says it, everyone is happy. Now, let me explain something to you. Again, for the umpteenth time, these men that you complain about came out of your vagina. You raised him. And I don't know why you guys think you're so much of a big catch. Like, I can't find no good black men. No, a black man can't find a good black woman that hasn't had an abortion, that doesn't watch Love and Hip Hop, and doesn't follow white women for centuries. This is the reason why black men like white women, because you follow white women. Here it is right here. Here are the receipts. She say jump, you say how high. This is ridiculous. And I apologize to the brothers. I should have got on this sooner, but I'm just now finding out about it. I kid you not. I'm just now finding out about this about 5, 6, 7 hours ago, be honest with you. It already went viral. And see, you got to understand something, brothers. Black women made that go viral. They shared that until they couldn't share it no more. They shared that until they went to sleep at night. They woke up the next morning and shared it again. They talked about it with their sisters. And see, this is what I'm talking about. This is exactly what I'm talking about when you have a bunch of women that are not team players. They are, and see, they'll listen to a white woman before they listen to you, brothers. They'll listen to a homosexual before they listen to you. They'll listen to a lizard. They don't like you. They have no respect for heterosexual black men. They don't like you. They hate your guts. This is the proof. And for when you brothers come to my channel, now I'm going to call you brothers, you pro-black men. Come to my channel and you try to tell me that you love a black woman and I'm bashing a black woman. Next time you do that, you'll be deleted and blocked. I don't want you on my channel talking that nonsense when they're behaving like this. They're trying to assassinate your character because they assassinated their character on the D Challenge. They're not doing no videos about that. They don't have no videos to say black women stop doing deep challenges, right? And then this one black girl did a comment and said, black women need to start locking that you know what up. Ain't nobody trying to smash you. That's why you're doing pee challenges, to give it away. The fact that these white women can find good men, but you can't. She played with y'all. She clearly played with you. And then in the article, she said an independent woman. That right there should have let you know she was trolling your stupid ass. And the reason why that should have let you know is because the average white woman comes from a patriarch. So why would she praise a strong and independent woman? You're not bright. You're dumb. And I hate to keep bringing this Kanika Jenkins up, because it showed, you know, the level of respect that you guys actually have for Black America. And again, brothers, this is a teachable moment, how they put all that time and effort into trying to find Kanika Jenkins' murderer, but she couldn't find the, they can't find the time and effort to put in to find their goddamn baby daddy. They can't find the time and effort into fixing Black America and fixing their reputation, but they're all over the Kanika Jenkins case, which millions of them got wrong. You all got it wrong. You guys are a complete embarrassment. And the more you mess up, and you guys don't really have a choice about dating black men. I hear a lot of you guys say, oh, I don't date black men no more. We don't care. No one dates you anyway. So it doesn't matter what you say. You were voted the least attractive person, the least liked person. So by you saying that you don't like someone or you don't want to date anyone, that goes in one ear and out the other, because no one cares about your opinion. I was looking at Tommy Sotomayor, and he does, you know, videos on black women all the time. People who don't know them, majority don't know him, majority do know him. And you have black women decapitating their sons, setting their sons on fire, riding around with dead bodies in the back of their trunk for 2-3 months, selling other black women in prostitution and sex trades. And then you guys come on YouTube and type that crap about black men like you're innocent, like you've been done so, oh my God. And these are the men that came out of your stanky vagina. I was also looking at Kanika Jenkins' mom when the police came and got her, and she was standing in front of her daughter's frozen body and didn't touch her daughter, didn't say anything. Just stood there with her blonde hair and looked stupid. She can't even put together a sentence to save her life. She's illiterate. The fact that you guys gave her a pass on her raising her daughter, and you continuously blaming the hotel. You guys are a bunch of jokes. There's a viral video of Donald Trump shaking people's hand, and you have a black woman trying to shake his hand, and he refused to shake the black woman's hand. It went viral. It's even on World Star Hip Hop. This is the way the world thinks of you. No one respects you. All you do is go around and kiss the white woman ass. Just like this Cardi B. Y'all more crying about her being light-skinned versus her being a bad influence on your daughters. You don't care about her being a bad influence on her, on your daughters. You're more worried about, damn, she's getting married already. Oh, it's a light-skinned girl getting ready to, all y'all worried about is skin color. That's the only thing on your mind in Black America. That white woman own you. She say jump, you say how high. She say get out my face, you say yes, ma'am. Tiffany Jolen went in on, her friend went in on black women, and she went in and called her homeless and all kind of crap. She don't like you either. She did that to troll you because she knows she run you. She own you. You've been bought and paid for since the 1960s, since you sold out and went into feminism and sold the whole black race down the drain. These are facts. This is not my opinion. These are facts. And I never do videos like this, so you know I'm not happy. I'm not a happy camper. I never do videos like this with my tone of voice like this. This is ridiculous. Then you got Simone Monkey 56. I mean, she never does videos until it's time to rub something in black men's face. Go to her catalog and click on videos. Look at her videos and see the last time she uploaded. She don't upload. She just upload to rub stuff in black men's face. Now, this is a 40 or 50 year old woman that isn't married, don't have kids. Men, she's the ugliest thing you're going to see. And she's trying to tell black women how to deal with men, and she doesn't have a man. You can't make this crap up. You guys are the big, and you see why your men are, and see now pro-black men are coming out against you. They're looking at you. I was looking at Mr. Superboy 223, and even he going in on your asses now. They like, God damn, these brothers over here got a point. Yeah, we got several points. You jacked up. You insane in the membrane. Locking yourself in freezers. Aborting 20 million babies. You nutcase. You are a nutcase. The fact that that woman can freestyle and write an article that she just, you can tell the way the article was written. And trust me, she's with a black man right now. Right now, as I speak, she probably giving him head. And I've done many stories about the city of North Hollywood, Van Nuys, where white women go to the gym, get butts, get a tan, and wear cornrows and date black men. And so, you know what? Ask Tariq Nasheed. He lives in North Hollywood. He'll tell you. Well, Van Nuys, that area, it's the same area. North Hollywood, Van Nuys is all in the same area, okay? Or he lives around that area. He'll tell you that too. So 9 times out of 10, you got to understand when a white woman write an article like that, it's fishy. And especially when she dates a black man, it's fishy. She's trolling you. Everyone is trolling you because you're easily trolled. And you go to bed and you believe this stuff. And you wake up and you see a video like mine and you get a reality check. Y'all sat up there in the Kanika Jenkins case. Y'all sat up there and gave out all those people information. The mother kept canceling going to her to protest about her daughter. She didn't start going to the protest until people start calling her out online. The mother can't even put together a sentence. She's illiterate. And you guys are still trying to blame the hospital. I'm so mad. I'm talking about the hospital. The hotel. The hospital. The hotel. You guys are unfit to be mothers. And I hope, you know, and you black men, I want to tell you, the black men that come to my channel and listen to me and try to find something to critique me on or cry about, I hope you guys do a video on this too, you punks, your mama's boys. The rest of you guys in this sector that cater to the black women. And I'm not going to say your name, but I had an issue with you monkeys a couple of months ago. Hopefully you'll do a video on this also. More likely you're not, because, you know, when it comes to donations and when people cater, they don't say too much. That's why I don't collect donations, because I want to say what the hell I want to say. This is ridiculous. This article, you can clearly, it's no different than the article of the homosexual. What he wrote talking about black men or the white people of black people. It's no different than what that homosexual said. Y'all didn't critique him because he's a homosexual. But if he was a heterosexual black man, you would have said, you know, that wasn't right. You guys are retarded people. And see, if I wasn't a black person, I wouldn't fuck with black people either. I might just be racist. I'm there with black people. And not so much the men, right? And I mean the like-minded men, black men. I have to make a difference because people will take things the wrong way. My SYSBM brothers and the like-minded brothers, you know I'm not talking about you. I'm talking about the rest of those idiots out there that refuse to call these women out. They making crap go viral about you. They did everything in their power to make this article go viral. Don't be surprised if the homosexual men start doing videos on this also, because they're teammates. Remember, the white woman is not a teammate with the black woman. The white woman don't like the black woman. The white woman uses the black woman so she can get over whatever she's trying to get. Meanwhile, she's in bed with the black man. Everyone knows the white woman is sucking more black cock than anybody. That should tell you that article was crap. But the average black woman don't know anything. She's an idiot. She's dumb as fuck. She's dumb as a doorknob. She is retarded. She is dumb. There's no way. You are the dumbest person in the history of people. I don't know how God stuck us down here with you. This is a punishment. You are dumb. You are an embarrassment. You don't do no research. A white woman can say, get on the feminist movement. Hear your black ass come. Yes, a white woman. The white woman say, here, start buying weaves. Y'all turn into a $15 billion industry. White woman tell you, Margaret Zinger tell you, go abort babies. You go and abort it. Y'all sit up here and you vote Democrat damn near 50, 60, 70 years and got nothing out of it. The Mexicans vote Democrat for what, 10 years and made California into a sanctuary state. That's how dumb y'all are. That's how pathetic you are. You're running around here talking about black men are broke when you only got a $5 network. You're worth $5 and you're telling black men we're broke. It makes no sense. You're running around here saying Kanika Jenkins was murdered when the autopsy says otherwise, but the real murderers are you with 20 million abortions since 1973. How do you murder 20 million fetuses? That is unheard of. But you're hopping on a white woman's back because she says something that you like. Because you feel bad because people are roasting you about the D challenge. You're so pathetic, you're trying to give it. You got millionaire black woman, Issa Rae, and gotta give it away because nobody want it. This is how pathetic you guys got. And I don't care who don't like it. I'm not here to tell you what you want to hear. Now, to some people, this is music to their ears. They're like, yeah, get them, kid. I know I'm snapping like I'm at an auction right now. 100, 200, 300, over there, 300, 400, 500. Yeah, man, because y'all ridiculous. This is ridiculous. This is an embarrassment to you, not black men. Because when this get out and people see that she has an issue with black women too, you're going to look stupid like you always look stupid because you jumped the gun before you do your research. You guys aren't bright people. You're dumb. Y'all are dumb as shit. There's no way around it. You are an embarrassment. All this shit going on in America, and it's all you can come up with? This all the black woman can come up with. Nothing about you is authentic. Nothing. You're a feminist. You wouldn't be a feminist if it wasn't for white women. You wouldn't wear weaves if it wasn't for white women. You wouldn't bleach your skin if it wasn't for white women. There's nothing about you authentic. But you're running around here acting like you talking about you want a real man. You're not going to get a real man when everything on you is fake. Even your attitude. Let's get back on Kanika Jenkins again. Because y'all dropped the ball on that one. Y'all, and I'm not going to do a video on that. It's not worth it. I'll just deal with that here because I'm tying that in to this here, how you guys jumped the gun. You never know what you're talking about. You never, ever know what you're talking about. You don't have a clue about anything but how to sew in fake hair. And follow a white woman around like a puppy. That's all you do. This is feminism 2.0, but this time she got you the next day. You didn't see the first time you joined feminists, you had to wait till maybe the 90s or the 80s to understand that you messed up. This time, a day or 2 days later, you found out that you messed up. And to you black men in this sector that cater to black women, that cater and, you know, for their donations and be, you know, because people found out your scheme. So you got to cater to the black woman now. Hopefully you speak out against this, because this is assassinating your character. Also, you are a heterosexual black male. Can you please speak out against this? Can we get some videos rolling to counter this BS argument, this BS story? This is ridiculous. And let me tell black women something. You see what I'm doing? When someone assassinates your character, this is what you do. You come out and you speak out against it. Okay? This is what you do. The only time you guys, and I challenge anyone, go, any black woman in this sector, go to her catalog. She doesn't speak out against anything except heterosexual black males. And when I was watching Terrain Rain's video, and shout out to that brother, man. If it wasn't for him, this video would not be possible. I don't think I would have went into her Facebook and dissected it like he did. And I know some of these people that I have an issue with, he's cool with. But, you know, it is what it is. And a video came up in my suggestion box to, you know, when you get a suggested video to watch. And it was a video by New Possibilities. And he was talking about this, calling people coons and all this other stuff. And this is a heterosexual black male taking the side of a white woman and taking the side of a bunch of women that are throwing his ice cream scoop head ass under the bus. Now, he's been defending black women for 10 years or something, and they do not respect him. They barely tell him thank you. This guy is another pathetic pro-black simp. They don't respect you, dude. They don't. They do not, under no circumstances, support you. They support everyone but you. You even had to go to Angel Ramirez's page to even get any type of recognition. And then, even though you came to them and said, I'm on your side, they still don't support you. You're dumb. You an idiot too. You're stupid. And that's what you get. And stay in your lane, homie. Stay in your lane. I'm out. Peace.